Good day, students. Welcome to math.serve.com. In this clip, we're going to be going over how to apply one of the differentiation techniques, which is the chain rule. We're going to apply it in finding the derivative of composite functions. Don't forget to visit our website at math.serve.com for access to a wide variety of math tutorials, ranging from algebra to calculus. All right, before we get started, let's go over the chain rule real quick, the formula that's going to guide our differentiation process. So the chain rule. The chain rule is basically applicable to composite functions. Okay, let's just take a look at the composition of two functions. So let's say we have a composite function, y equals f composed with g of x. Okay, I'm going to color code it so we can keep track of what's going on. So let's say we have this composite function y composed with g of x. Then the derivative y prime is going to be the derivative of this composite function f of g of x prime, the entire composite function prime. The chain rule is that the derivative of this composite function is f prime of g of x multiplied by g prime of x, okay, multiplied by g prime of x. All right, so another name for a chain rule, for the chain rule, is known as the outside-inside rule. Basically, you have a function on the outside and then another function on the inside. So which function is on the outside, which function is on the inside? If you take a look at the original situation that we have right here, f is on the outside. This is a function on the outside. And so let's call this the outside function. And g is the function on the inside. Okay, so we're composing f with g. So the derivative basically tells you that you are going to find the derivative of the outside function. The derivative of the outside function evaluated at the inside function. Okay, so you differentiate the outside function and then you plug in the inner function, or it's called the function on the inside. And then you multiply that by the derivative of the inside function, okay? Inside function prime. So outside function prime of the inside function times the inside function prime will give us a derivative. Now, this notation looks very confusing. A lot of students confuse the functions, the outer and the inner functions. So in order to keep it clean and avoid confusion and clutter, most textbooks make use of a substitution called the U substitution, okay? So to keep our work nice and pretty, we're gonna say let the inner function g of x be u. So let u equal g of x, all right? So that's gonna give us the formula we're going to be using today, which is f prime of the inner function, instead of g of x, just to make it look good, we're gonna call it u times u prime, okay, times u prime. So this is derivative of the outside evaluated at the inner function times the derivative of the inside function, all right? This is equivalent, this is known as the Lagrange notation. The Lagrange notation, you see it in some books. If you have d dx of a composite function f of u, okay, you have a composite function like this. This is the same thing as, well, let's just call it the derivative of a composite function y. Okay, so d dx of y. If y is a composite function, dy dx, it's going to be written as dy du times du dx. Now, this is exactly the same thing as what we have here. Dy du is the derivative of the outside function evaluated at an inner function, and then du dx is the derivative of an inner function. Okay, so these two formulas are exactly the same thing, okay? All right, so with that in mind, let's go ahead and try out two examples. Now, what we're going to be doing today, we're going to be taking a look at some AP calculus type questions, the kind of questions you see in the AP calculus exam. So let's take a look at question number one, find y prime, where y is a composite function, x to the third minus cosine x, and then this entire quantity raised to the fifth power. All right, so we're going to go step by step with this problem so everybody understands it. First thing we're going to do, let me call it, rewrite my function as a composition of two functions. So let y equals f of g of x. Okay. Now, so f of g of x, which is equal to x to the third power. Let's color code our function. So the inner function is x to the third minus cosine x, and then that entire quantity raised to the fifth power. All right, so before we start making our u substitution and applying this formula right here, let's go ahead and identify our outer and inner functions, okay? So that's the formula I'm going to be using. So my outside function, we can call it outer, outside is what? F of x equals, it's the fifth power polynomial, okay? So it's x to the fifth. That's the outer function, the outside function, okay? So the inside function, do you see what the inside function is? Let's call for that also. And the outside function is x to the fifth power. The inside function is, let's call that g, is x to the third minus cosine x, okay? So the inside function is x to the third minus cosine x. Now, if you compose f and g, hopefully you can see that this would be the result. If you compose f and g, you evaluate f of x to the fifth at x to the third minus cosine x. Namely, plug this into the x, you have x to the third minus cosine x raised to the fifth power. Okay? So now we know our outside and inside function. To make this work pretty and easy on the eyes, we're going to make use of the u substitution, okay? So how do we make use of the u substitution? We're going to call the inner function u. Okay, so let u be equal to g of x. So if u is equal to g of x, now I can make use of my formula. Y prime is simply going to be f prime of u, f prime of u multiplied by u prime. Okay? Remember, this is just to make our lives easy. When we're done, we have to put our result in terms of x. Okay, so we'll just keep that in mind. We still have to convert it back to the original form. We're shifting formats here so that it's easy for us to compute. Okay, so this is the formula we're going to be using. Now, what we need, if you look at this formula, we need f prime of u, and we also need u prime. All right, so let's go ahead and figure them out. I like to start with the inner functions, easier to work with. So let's call, what is u? If u is g of x, then u is x to the third minus cosine x. Okay? If u is x to the third minus cosine x, then that follows that u prime, the derivative of the inner function is 3x squared, using the power rule. The derivative of negative cosine is negative. I'm sorry, the derivative of cosine is negative sine. And then if you take the opposite of negative sine because of this minus here, you have plus sine x. Okay? So we have u prime. That's good. Now, what is f of u? What is f of u? This is a little bit tricky, probably the trickiest part in the whole process. What is f of u? Let's go back to the outside function. The outside function f of x is x to the fifth. So f of u just simply involves replacing x with u. So f of u is going to be u to the fifth power. Okay? So if f of u is u to the fifth power, then f prime of u is, we're just going to apply the power rule here. F prime of u is going to be 5u to the fourth power. Okay? All right, so we have everything we need. Remember here, we just need f prime of u times u prime. If you were using the Leibniz notation, this is dy du, and then this is du dx. Same thing, okay? All right, so let's go ahead and put them together. We're going to have y prime is going to be f prime of u is 5u to the fourth times u prime. See, this is u prime right here, 3x squared plus sine x. Encapsulate that quantity in parentheses, okay? So what would have been done if our function were in terms of x? Remember, the original problem was in terms of x. There are no u's there. But we have a u and an x here, so we need to address this variable. We need to convert it back to what it was. What is u? U is x to the third minus cosine x. So we're going to plug this back into the function, okay? So our final answer, y prime, is going to be 5 times u, which is x to the third minus cosine x, times u prime, which is 3x squared. I feel like I'm leaving something out. Yeah, there's a 4 right here. 3x squared plus sine x. Okay, so let's go over this again. This first piece right here is the derivative of the outside function evaluated at the inside times the derivative of the inside function. Okay, so there goes the derivative of y. All right, now let's go ahead and take a look at another example. All right, so for number two, we have y equals, we have a composite function. Again, y equals e to the tan x minus 2. Okay? All right, so let's see here. First thing we want to do is we want to express this as a composite function. Okay? So, let's go ahead and write down what we're supposed to do. So if you have this, we want to find y prime. Okay? Want to find y prime or dy dx. Okay, so let's express this as a composite function. Y, in this case, we're composing two functions. So we're going to be using f and g. So y is equal to f of g of x. Okay, in this situation, we have f of g of x, which is e to the tan x minus 2. Okay? All right, so do you see the outer and the inner function? The outside and the inner function here. Do you see it? Let's go ahead and write it down. So the outside function is f of x, of course. And f of x is, in this situation, is e to the x minus 2. Blind yourself to this inner function, just call it x, okay? And then the function on the inside, let's call that g of x, is this function right here, tan x, okay? So we have our outside and the inner function. The formula I want to use involves u. I like to have it looking nice and pretty, so I'm going to say let's make use of u here, okay? So let u equals g of x. If u is equal to g of x, then I can use the simplified form of the formula for the chain rule. Y prime equals f prime of u times u prime. Okay? Times u prime. Derivative of the outside function evaluated at the inside times the derivative of the inside function. Okay? All right, so I need f prime of u and u prime. What are they? Let's go ahead and figure out what they are. We'll start with the inside function. So we're going to say the inside function u is equal to g of x, right? And g of x is tan x. Okay? So if u is tan x, then u prime, the derivative of tan, is secant square x. All right? So we have one piece down. We know what u prime is. The next thing we need to find is f prime of u, okay? So before we can find the derivative, we need to know what the function is. F of u, what is f of u? Now, if you look at what we talked about earlier here, the outside function is e to the x minus 2. So f of u is going to be e instead of u. I'm sorry, instead of x is going to be e to the u as a composite function. Minus 2. All right, so if this is f of u, then what is f prime of u? What is f prime of u? The derivative of e to the x is just e to the x. So the derivative of e to the u is simply going to be e to the u, and then the derivative of negative 2 using the constant rule is going to be 0. Okay, all right, so we have all the ingredients that we need. We have u prime, and we have f prime of u. All right, so y prime is going to now be, we put them together. F prime of u is e to the u times u prime, which is secant square x. Okay, are we done? The answer is no. Remember, y is a function of x. Okay, so we have a u here, which is not acceptable. We have to convert it back to its original form. We know that u is tan x, so we have to use that to finish up the problem. E to the, instead of u, e to the tan x secant square x is the derivative of y. Okay, so there goes your derivative. So thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. We really appreciate it. Feel free to subscribe to our channel for updates to other cool tutorials such as this. And you can give us a thumbs up if you liked it. We really appreciate it. And do post a comment in the comment section if you have any questions, clarifications, or suggestions as to how we can improve our tutorials. Don't forget to visit us at matgutserve.com for more videos. Thanks again for watching and have a wonderful day.